Good morning, YouTube world. Today's Thursday, March 14th, and I have a bare face this morning. I said I wanted to, I have on eyeshadow, but that's it. A regular lip gloss, that's what I'm going to do. No makeup, no lip liner, no eyeliner. See, ooh, I'm hit. I have a mark on from this hat, but no eyeliner, no anything. To try to start, I don't know, just getting a different look, and I do look like a completely different person with no lip liner on. I look weird. I look prosthetic or something. I don't know. But anyway, I feel great. I've been having issues with, I think maybe like my blood sugar, or I forgot what the condition was, or it's something dealing with oxygen getting to your brain. I remember the doctor advised me, some people, they just have to take their time getting up slower than others. This happened to me about maybe 4 times within a 6 month. Yeah, about 4 times within a 6 month time frame. And maybe the 4th time was last night. Thought I was dying. It was, first of all, when I dozed off and I was laid down, it was a little chilly in my house. So I turned the heat up to maybe 80. And you know how my house is, turn it up high, it kicks on a little quicker. But within that time frame, I dozed off. So when I woke up, I would jump up to use the restroom. A lot of times I just jump up fast and just hurry up and go to the bathroom, instead of just when I wake up later for 5 seconds at least, then, you know, take my time getting out of the bed or anything like that. But I don't know, I'm always just jump up thinking I'm late, or so I guess it's a habit, even late in midnight hour when I'm using the restroom. But for me jumping up to, I had on a turtleneck, but it was like thin. I mean, like almost paper thin, those form-fitting ones, kind of slim you out. And so with that, with the heat being on like 80, I just got so lightheaded. And, but even though I had on a turtleneck, that had nothing to do with it, because I, like I said, this is the 4th time within a 6 month time frame this has happened. What happens is I get up and like feel like I can't catch my breath. My head starts spinning, and it feels like someone's like maybe choking me or something. But it was just so scary. The first time that it happened, I literally thought I was gonna die. I actually passed out for a little bit in front of my son. And as I was going down to faint, you know, I called on Jesus. And I'm just thinking about when it happened. It was just so terrifying. I called on the Lord, and in my head, I couldn't speak as I was going down. I said, Father, if you're going to take me, please don't let me go like this in front of my son, Jared. He's 10. We're very close. And, you know, just even as a child seeing anyone, you know, pass out, let alone die, and then if it being their parent, it just wouldn't have been good. So, you know, they're going to the hospital, things like that. You can. Thank you.
Okay.
Sorry about that. I was going to say, and then the next time it happened, I remember the first time. I kind of just like took soft breaths and things like that, and I calmed down. You know, if you panic, you drown, things like that. So it was okay. The third time it happened, it was a little scary again, but I got through it. But last night, usually, like the last 3 times that happened, I try to like lift my hands up, like trying to get the oxygen to, you know, I guess balance out. And that slash, Jesus help me. And then I just kind of walk slow, and I'm so hot, it feels like I need cold air, whether it's just put the AC on, jump in front of a fan, stick my head in the freezer, throw cold water on my face. And I guess that quick reaction actually like makes it worse. I don't know what would be going on in my body or things like that. But I called Jared, you know, just so he can be aware of what's going on in case he has to call 911. But this is the first time it happened, like late at night. It was like, what, 3 a.m. And he's a hard sleeper, you know, and I just kept saying, Jared, like screaming. He could not hear me. And I really thought that I was going to die last night. I started to go toward my door. I just started stripping. That's how hot I was. Start taking my clothes off. Not even like, okay, my son, wake up. He'll send me my bra and underwear. I was just so hot, like, just feel like I was suffocating. I was trying to do anything. And I said, well, I don't want to die in the doorway. And my son, I was just thinking all a bunch of crazy stuff. So, you know, I made it to the bathroom and put cold water in my face. It seemed like it helped, but I still seemed like I was going to pass out. So kept calling on Jesus, leaned down on the sink, then laid on the floor. And it took maybe about 5 minutes, but those 5 minutes seemed like 5 hours, literally. And I was okay. And I laid on the couch. And then I felt like, okay, you don't need to lay down. You need to sit up. So I couldn't bend down, so I walked over. My son was actually laying on the living room floor, and I was on the couch. So I kind of, like, tapped on my foot to wake him up. And he knew, because it happened before, like, okay, she's having one of these moments again. And I explained, I said, Jared, Mommy thought she was going to actually die for real tonight. So, you know, of course, he was frightened and things like that. So he hugged me and was praying with me. And he got up on the couch. I curled up by him, and, you know, we prayed, and I felt horrible because he was acting like such an adult. He sat up and just watched me. So we talked about it this morning, and he said, Mom, if you'd have died while I was here and while I was asleep, I'd have never forgiven myself because I'd have felt like I could have helped you and I couldn't have. And I explained to him, trying to calm him down, you know, Jared, even if something would have happened, it wouldn't have been your fault, you know. You know, I try to eat right, do the right things, go to the doctors. I don't know what's going on. I have a very, very bad case of anemia. You know, have to constantly eat tons of green things, take tons of iron pills. I'm B negative, he's B positive. I don't know. So that's actually, I'm just glad to be alive. I wouldn't even wish that on my worst nightmare. I wasn't fearful as far as like, oh, I'm going to go to hell, or, no, of course, I hope I'm living right, that I wouldn't have that concern, but it was just more so, God, if you're going to take me, please don't let me go like this in front of my son. Can you imagine my son waking up and trying to wake me up? You know, usually how he comes in and just like kiss me or hug me, try to wake me up, and I'm cold, or, you know, that would just jack any child up, so I'm just grateful that the Lord saw fit to not take my life. I hope I can figure out what's going on. If it's something that the doctors can figure out or God can show me, like, what I need to start doing or stop doing as far as my diet. I don't know. Or does this mean something spiritually? I don't know. So I'm just grateful to just be here today. If you notice a couple of my videos, you know, I always start off the first video I do, happy to be alive, everyone didn't wake up today, blah, blah. Yes, of course, you know, I have things put in place in case I die. Insurance policies, plots are paid, beneficiaries, things like that. But who actually wants to use insurance policies? I'm 40 and I want to see my son, you know, get older, get married, things like that. I want to see God, you know, use my twins. I want to see Jalen and Janaea living right, doing right, you know, from A to Z. Bad behaviors they have, I want them to be delivered. You know, I want to see the Coleman family as a whole, come together, make up, act like a loving family like we used to. There's other dreams, goals, and aspirations I don't want to see come to pass for myself. So, no, I don't want to leave yet. But, yeah, that's about it for right now. Let me see, I've been talking for 10 minutes and 20 seconds. So, grateful to be alive. Thanks for watching and be blessed. Thanks.